மார்கழி மந்த் 17th டே, திருப்பாவை பாசுரம் 17. அம்பரமே தண்ணீரே சோரே அறம் செய்யும் எம்பெருமான் நந்தகோபாலா எழுந்திராய். கொம்பனார்க்கெல்லாம் கொழுந்தே குளவிளக்கே எம்பெருமாட்டி யசோதாய் அறிவுராய். அம்பரம் ஊடறுத்து ஒங்கி உலகளந்த உம்பர் கோமானே உறங்காது எழுந்திராய். செம்போர் கடலடி செல்வா பலதேவா உம்பியும் நீயும் உரங்கேலூர் ரெம்பாவாய். ஸோ இன் திஸ் பாசுரம் ஆண்டாள் அலாங் வித் அதர் கேர்ள்ஸ் என்டர் நந்தகோபால ஹவுஸ். ஷீ காட் பர்மிஷன் ஃப்ரம் தி காட்ஸ் டு என்டர் தி ஹவுஸ் அண்ட் ஷீ வெண்ட் இன் வித் அதர் கேர்ள்ஸ் அண்ட் தே வேர் ட்ரைங் டு வேக் அப் த ஃபாதர் நந்தகோபாலா, மதர் யசோதா, பிரதர் பலராமா, தென் கிருஷ்ணா. வென் ஆண்டாள் ட்ரைஸ் டு wake up Nandagopala, she says the good qualities of Nandagopala, because she is a charity minded, she is a donor of food, water and clothes. So Andal refers all that. Andal says that you give whatever is needed by the people and you share everything with the people. You are a very generous person. So here we are also for getting a dana from you. That is, we like to have darshan of Krishna. So please allow us to wake up Krishna. So that was the request made by Andal to Nandagopala. She was very sure Nandagopala is a very soft-hearted man, so he would allow. Then she goes to Yashoda, the mother. She says, Yashoda, you are a woman who supports, who helps all the women of Ayarpadi, and you understand their feelings, their difficulties, and help them on time. You please understand my feeling too. I'd like to see Krishna. So please help me to wake him up. Then they go to Krishna. And they tried to wake up Krishna, but they couldn't, because Balarama had to be woken up. So they go to Balarama and they say, Chempur Kadaladi Chalva, that is, you have got the feet, like a golden feet. So she's describing Balarama and asking him to wake up. She was very sure that only the brother wakes up, Krishna will wake up. So they asking Balarama to wake up Krishna. So she is following that protocol, waking up father first, then mother, then brother, then Krishna. And she is asking Balarama, both of you and your brother, please get up, and we are all waiting for his darshan. We all want to have his presence when we do our nonbu. So through this we find Andal is waking up the entire family. Today's temple is Ranganatha Perumal Temple, Adi Thiruvarangam, Vizhuppuram, Tamil Nadu. This temple is dedicated to Lord Vishnu. Lord Vishnu appears here as Ranganathar. Ranganathar in reclining position on five-headed Adisheshan. Sri Devi and Bhudevi are also seated here with Sri Ranganathar. Ranganathar has mace near his arm. There is an image of Garuda near the feet of Sri Ranganathar, and Moolavar Vigraham is nearly 29 feet long, and Vigraham is made of herbs. Ranganathar here, that is the period of this temple and the period of this Moolavar Vigraham, is much older than the Vigraham of Srirangam. So this place existed much before than Srirangam. This is the information given by Archakas. And this temple is almost 2000 years old. And wherever we have Ranganathar temple, we find he lies along the river bed. So here also we find Pennai River flows. The story, that is Stala Purana of this temple, is once Devas were troubled by a demon called Somukhan. And Somukhan wanted to have entire control of Devas. He conquered the place of the kingdom of Devas and took away the Vedas. And Somukhan hid the Vedas somewhere. Devas prayed to Lord Vishnu. So Lord Vishnu took up Matsya avataram and he killed Somukhan. He recovered the Vedas from him and taught the Vedas to Brahma here. And the Devas requested Vishnu to show his form during night. That is how he is seen in Tiruparkadal. So pleased by the devotion of Devas, Vishnu is believed to have appeared in Ranganathar form here and gave them darshan. There is another Purana attached to this. Once the moon god, that is Chandra, he suffered due to the curse of his wives. So he lost his luster and began to fade. He approached Narada Maharishi. As Narada advised, Chandra came to this place to worship Lord Vishnu, and he did penance here and got his curse removed. So here this spring is known as Chandra Pushkarani. Then later Devas appealed to Lord Vishnu that he should make this place his abode. Responding to their prayers, Perumal, that is Lord Vishnu, asked the Devas sculptor Vishwakarma to make an idol, and a big idol was made by him in a reclining form, and that was installed here. Lord Vishnu fulfilled the prayers of the Devas and is grazing the devotees this day. And there is another incident happened. Surakirti, he was a king. The king did not have child, so he was praying for that. And he came, he visited this place, this temple, and he prayed to Lord Ranganatha, and his prayers were listened by the God, and he got children. He contributed a lot for this temple. So this temple has got many features, like pillared hall, then Artha Mandapa, Unjal Mandapa, and Kalyana Mandapa. So before we go to Sanctum Sanctorium, the big hall, that is Artha Mandapa, we find all the idols of Alvars. So it's like a hall where the idols of Alvars are kept. So we find many features here. A long corridor with pillars, the pillared mandapam. This temple was not visited by Alvars, though it belonged to the very old period. The temple had a very good outer pradakshina path, where we find number of inscriptions, pillared hall, mandapams. When you come out of the Dvajastampa, we find a huge granary almost near the entrance. This granary looks very old, and finding granary inside the temple, it is very uncommon. Earlier the temples were the center of the village, center of the town, center of the living area of the people, and temple served the purpose of institution, education institution and other social activities. So this would have been built here within the temple compound, and people say this temple was used for storing grains, and those grains would have been supplied by the local people. They would have stored their grains here, or the rich people would have donated some portion of their grains and they were stored here. But we don't find any information about this. But it stands as a symbol of the lifestyle of the olden times.